I will speak about the novelties that we obtained recently on our favorite commensal beneficial bacterium, Faecalibacterium prausnitzii. In fact, in 2008, with my friend and colleague Harry Sokol, we were the first to identify among the gut microbiota a beneficial commensal bacterium based on human clinical data. Because in fact, we observed that in Crohn's disease patients in relapse, there is a lack of Faecalibacterium prausnitzii in contrast to what was observed in Crohn's disease patients in remission. So we hypothesized that this bacterium could have anti-inflammatory properties. And in fact, we have published these results in 2008 in PNAS. And this paper is one of the most 10 most cited papers in the gut microbiota domain. So since 2008, we have progressed a lot on Faecalibacterium prausnitzii, and notably on the mode of action of Faecalibacterium prausnitzii. We have worked intensively on what we have identified as one of the main anti-inflammatory effectors, which is called MAM protein, for microbial anti-inflammatory molecule. So in 2018, we were able to raise funds in order to create a startup, which is called Excellium Biosciences. And the aim of our startup, in fact, is to provide a parallel treatment to Crohn's disease patients, because in fact, what we are observing is at this time, the existing therapies for Crohn's disease are focused on the dysregulation of the immune system, and none is acting on the dysbiosis observed in the gut microbiota of these Crohn's disease patients. So our proposal is to administer in parallel with existing treatments our bug Faecalibacterium prausnitzii. So since 2018, we have progressed a lot because now we have succeeded in the industrial scale-up in order to get GMP biomass which can be administered to CD patients. And at this time, we are working with European Medical Agency in order to get the authorization to start the first human clinical trial in CD patients with Faecalibacterium prausnitzii. In parallel to this success with our startup in my lab, we are trying to use Faecalibacterium prausnitzii in other diseases. And as we know that Faecalibacterium prausnitzii is very efficient in order to restore a good intestinal permeability, we have tested it in pelvic radiation diseases in many cancer patients. After irradiation, they have huge intestinal disorders, and we have observed in irradiated rats a very beneficial effect of Faecalibacterium prausnitzii in order to restore these gastrointestinal disorders. And more recently, as in COVID-19 hospitalized patients, we have observed also gastrointestinal disorder with a dysbiosis and especially a decrease in Faecalibacterium prausnitzii population. We have established a collaboration with one ANSES laboratory in east of France, and they have a very good expertise in a SARS-CoV-2 infection of hamsters. And we have tried oral administration of Faecalibacterium prausnitzii, and we were able to observe that using Faecalibacterium prausnitzii in these SARS-CoV-2 infected hamsters, we have a significant decrease of the viral load, and so we observed less SARS-CoV-2 in these infected hamsters. So we are very optimistic in order to use also Faecalibacterium prausnitzii in COVID-19 hospitalized patients in order to restore the homeostasis of their gut microbiota. So that's all for today. And so I have summarized what we are doing with our startup, and also what we are doing in my lab in Juan Josas in the Michaelis Institute of INRAE.